Liz, and I'm here today because I'd like to get the lumps removed on my neck and on my armpits. I saw a doctor and they told me I had steatocystoma multiplex. The reason I didn't get my bumps removed is because with six kids between the ages of 16 and 2 and a half, I don't have time to take care of myself. So I just left them where they were and had to deal with them.
Thank you. We're gonna go down to room 6, so straight ahead.
Okay. I brought my daughter Elsie with me today. Elsie's 5 years old and she has a lump on the top of her forehead. And as soon as I saw it, I was completely concerned that she had the same condition as me. I really hope that Dr. Lee can help Elsie, and I want to know that whatever's on her head isn't something that could be dangerous.
Oh, I see little legs around the corner. Hello. How are you? What can I do for you?
I have lumps.
Oh,
on
I
my
see.
Body.
I see. Okay.
This one is my least favorite because everybody looks at it.
And then I have the least favorite ones.
Oh, they seem like they're all your least favorite.
Yeah. Well, yes.
You can't gauge
those.
I see. In your armpit, your axilla here. Okay. Yeah. I'm glad this isn't a lipoma. I think that these are steatocystomas, which present their own challenges, but they're also really satisfying and fun. It's like a little treat squeezing the goo out of them. Do you know what these are?
Steatocystoma multiplex.
That's what it looks like.
Right.
We can take care of a lot of them, I think, that will bother you.
I'd rather have a line scar than these lumps.
Now, I also see this little kiddo here. What's going on with you? I couldn't help but notice you have a little bump on you, huh?
Tell her what we call it.
A unicorn horn.
And in the last year, it has probably doubled, maybe even tripled in size.
Steatocystomas can run in families.
It's squishy and hard.
I'm gonna take a little feel, okay? Oh, it is like a cute little horn up here, isn't it? See, it's really mobile. That's very good.
Yeah.
It doesn't really match with it. I think it could be what's called a pilomatrixoma. It's a different kind of cyst, a little bit rarer, but just kind of a little harder and misshapen, not a simple circle. But I don't think that it is life-threatening, because that's always a concern, you know?
Right.
Steatocystomas can be genetic, but they often pop up during puberty when your oil production is really ramped up. I don't think that's what Ellie has. I think that we're not going to really figure out what Ellie has until she actually gets her lump removed. So the way that I usually remove growths is under local anesthesia. And sometimes that's hard for younger people because it's harder for them to stay still. I think that the people in life that they're grown-ups and they're so fearful of doctors are those kids that have been held down. But I'm hoping maybe I can see you again when you get a little older, okay?
I'm glad that Elsie's lump is not dangerous and that Dr. Lee was able to put my fears to rest. Hearing Dr. Lee talk about, you know, the dangers of working on a young child, I completely understand that. It's important to be safe.
So just a little baby pinch here, just a baby pinch. That was work. I think I removed like 45 steatocystomas. My hands are exhausted, but I do think that Liz is gonna walk out of here with a little jingle in her step.
Holy crap.
They're nice and flat.
They're like gone. Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, especially those. I feel like I finally was able to take care of myself for the first time in forever, and I just feel like more alive.
Oh, I would give it a little sip.
She's gonna put a hat on it. It looks so silly.
So cute.
I feel much better about my bump now. I'll see Dr. Lee in a couple years and get my bump removed.
I'm a Kazuyo. I'm 73-year-old. I live in Hawaii for over 60 years. I have this bump. Lately, I start getting numbness on the thumb. It's affecting my job. That's what I'm scared for.
We're gonna go down the hall to room 6.
Okay. My job is a barber. I own the barber shop for 40 years. At work. Until I drop dead, I'm gonna cut in here. I hope today Dr. D can remove my bump from my arm so I can work better. That's gonna be the best Christmas present for me.
Kazuyo?
Yes, I am.
Ah, I'm Sandra. Nice to meet you. Very nice to meet you too. Welcome.
Thank you. Well, I come here for my bump over here.
It's yes.
Like a mochi.
Oh, yes. It is very mobile. It feels like it's probably a little lipoma mochi. Kazuya's bump does look a little like mochi, that Japanese dessert dumpling. I kind of see that, but I'm definitely not tasting it. Let's do it. That'll be a nice Christmas gift, huh? Yes, okay. This one feels like it could be another Christmas lipoma, but I really hope it isn't. I really hope this little mochi is filled with cyst-filled goodness.
I'm gonna be faint if I sit up a lot.
I'm gonna lean you back just a little farther then, okay?
Yes.
So you shouldn't feel anything other than us touching you. I do not like her lipoma, but I do love Kazuya. So I'm gonna make sure that I leave the teeniest scar on this pretty little lady at Christmas.
Wow.
You can bend your arm a little bit.
Right.
Just a little swollen because it's numb.
Oh, yes. I feel wonderful now, you know? Wonderful. No more mochi.
No more mochi.
Yes, somebody eat it.
Yeah, no, nobody ate it. It's here. Yeah, I don't know if it's pineapple or mango. Mango mochi, that's it.
I don't have a pressure after the surgery. So it's relief now. And Christmas season is a busy time for work. So, you know, I can go for it.
Good.
Thank you very much. You're so welcome.
So nice to
I have some
do
gift for you,
you
from
do?
Hawaii.
I thought this was your lunch.
It was a
Oh my goodness.
Is that a This is a hakule. Okay?
Oh yeah, go ahead.
Can I put it on?
Does it fit on me? Yes?
Yes.
Good.
Okay.
Oh, that's perfect.
Hakule is most of the time a happy occasion. Uh-huh. So this is for Christmas gift.
Oh, thank you.
You look like a Hawaii queen.
Yes. Oh. Thank you. Have a wonderful Christmas too. And I'm glad you have it without your mochi. No
Thank
mochi.
You so much.
Take care, okay? Aloha.
Aloha.
Bye.
Bye. This is a very wonderful gift that I got in my life. Thank you.
And my Starbucks.
When you speak to me next, you must address me as royalty.
That's so
just been donned the
really,
hakule
really
queen. She has this beautiful, is this not gorgeous? So I'm gonna keep this here right in front of my husband's desk so he can know that I'm the queen.
You're the queen, there you go.